Hello everyone. Today we're talking about a topic that is becoming essential for every organization: AI governance. Artificial intelligence is transforming industries worldwide: finance, healthcare, education, manufacturing. But at the same time, AI introduces risks, data breaches, algorithmic bias, model drift, and even ethical controversies. Here in Hong Kong, as a global financial hub and technology innovation center, these issues are even more pressing. Businesses must balance innovation with compliance, both locally and internationally. So the key question: who ensures that AI is safe, transparent, and compliant? One of the answers is ISO IEC 42001, the world's first international AI management system standard. ISO IEC 42001 was officially published in December 2023, and many call it the ISO 27001 of the AI era. It provides a full governance framework covering the entire AI lifecycle and is built on the Plan Do Check Act, PDCA, cycle. Its uniqueness lies in three main requirements: AI risk assessment, identifying and evaluating risks such as data bias, model drift, misuse, or privacy risks; AI impact assessment, considering not just technical risks, but also the broader impact on individuals, society, and the public interest; statement of applicability, SOA, every adopted or excluded control must be justified, ensuring traceability and accountability. In the Hong Kong market, this aligns perfectly with compliance needs. Local companies face PDPO, Personal Data Privacy Ordinance, requirements, as well as cross-border obligations under GDPR in Europe and PIPL in mainland China. ISO IEC 42001 offers a unified structure to integrate all of these. At the heart of ISO IEC 42001 is the PDCA cycle, ensuring AI governance is not a one-off project, but a continuous improvement loop. 1. Plan, define scope, identify AI risks and opportunities, set policies, objectives, and allocate resources. 2. Do, implement controls such as data governance, model testing, staff training, and compliance processes. 3. Check, regularly monitor and audit AI systems, verify compliance with regulations and organizational goals. IMRA 4. Act, apply corrective and preventive actions, optimize the system as laws and technologies evolve. For Hong Kong businesses, this approach is extremely practical. Regulations evolve quickly. For example, HKMA's guidance on AI risk, the generative AI application guidelines, and potential future amendments to PDPO. With PDCA, companies can adapt quickly instead of reacting only after issues arise, according to making the business case for ISO IEC 42001 certification. Many organizations adopt ISO IEC 42001 not just for the certificate, but to align with multiple regulatory frameworks. In Europe, it directly supports compliance with the EU AI Act, particularly for high-risk AI systems. In Canada, the trend under ADA requires responsible AI governance, and ISO 42001 provides a globally recognized framework to reduce cross-border friction. In Hong Kong and Asia, ISO 42001 complements the PDPO, HKMA AI guidelines, and the Hong Kong Generative AI guidelines, transforming high-level principles into auditable, practical management practices. For Hong Kong companies, this is critical. Financial institutions, multinational corporations, and AI startups alike face dual challenges: meeting local laws while proving international trustworthiness. Why adopt ISO IEC 42001? Three key reasons. 1. Ensure compliance. ISO IEC 42001 helps organizations prepare for the EU AI Act, Canadian AIDA, Hong Kong PDPO amendments, and future Asian regulations. 2. Build trust. Certification is more than compliance proof. It signals responsibility and transparency to customers, investors, and partners. In Hong Kong, where industries like finance and healthcare are tightly regulated, this trust is invaluable. 3. Competitive advantage. Compliance is becoming the license to operate. With ISO IEC 42001, Hong Kong companies can access new markets faster and avoid being excluded from international collaborations. Of course, Adopting ISO IEC 42001 comes with challenges. Standards are voluntary, laws are mandatory. Certification does not replace obligations under PDPO or HKMA rules. SMEs may struggle with resources. Many Hong Kong businesses are SMEs, and consulting or certification costs may be a barrier. Lack of localized guidance. More industry-specific case studies are needed in Hong Kong. Industry differences. AI in finance, healthcare, and education involves very different risks, requiring tailored controls. Without careful implementation, companies risk surface compliance without substance. Looking ahead, ISO IEC 42001 is likely to become the global benchmark for AI governance. Some emerging trends include Unified Control Framework, UCF, Mapping EU AI Act, ISO IEC 42001, and NIST RMF to reduce duplication. Five-layer governance model, from legislation, standards, certification, monitoring, improvement. Global AI Governance Index, AGIL. Benchmarking governance capabilities across countries. For Hong Kong businesses, early adoption means not just compliance, but also a first-mover advantage in global markets. To summarize, ISO IEC 42001 is not just a standard, it's an entry ticket to the international AI compliance ecosystem. It allows organizations to innovate while staying resilient, navigate between different regulatory systems, win trust and business opportunities in competitive markets. Here in Hong Kong, DQS HK provides full support, from gap analysis, system development, and internal audits to final certification. With over 35 years of global certification expertise and strong local regulatory knowledge, we help Hong Kong enterprises make ISO IEC 42001 truly effective. If your company is working on AI projects or planning to expand globally, ISO IEC 42001 is one of the smartest steps you can take. Remember, in the AI era, real innovation must be built on safety, compliance, and trust.